Hi, everybody. I'm NASA's Josh Byerly here in Mission Control, and I'm joined by my friend Chris Edelen, who is actually the Expedition 34 lead flight director, and that means he's got a fairly busy job over the last 5 months or so. But Chris, you know, we're getting ready to wrap up. Kevin Ford and Evgeny Tarelkin and Oleg Novitsky, you know, the time's almost done on board the space station. So talk a little bit about what this crew has done and, you know, what you've been up to.
Okay, well, it's been a very busy increment. The focus has been primarily on research and utilization, putting the space station to work. In fact, the primary focus of the crew and their motto is reflected in their crew patch, from the Earth for the Earth, and that reflects their desire to leave the confines of the Earth's gravity field, to get above the atmosphere, and to live and work in space, and to conduct research that not only advances the agency's exploration goals, but also benefits all of humanity.
So talk about, they set a record, right, for a number of hours spent working on science utilization. Talk a little bit about what they've done and some of the big things they've worked on.
Okay, yeah, and that's right. We're on track to set a record for total number of utilization hours, and that's NASA speak for scientific experiments,
right,
and research. And we also set a record for one-time hours in a specific week. So that really shows how the station program is maturing, and we're reaching the point we've gone from a focus on assembly operations now to utilization, so that the taxpayers get a return on their investment for the cost of building station. So again, we're learning how to more effectively and efficiently operate the station systems to free up more time for research. I'll give you a couple specific examples of some exciting experiments that are going on board the station right now. One of them is called CSLM. That's coarsening of solid liquid mixtures, and that's an experiment that flew up on the SpaceX Dragon. And here you can see Chris Hadfield working on CSLM in the microgravity science glove box. This is a material science experiment that examines how molten metals solidify, and in the solidification process, dendrites are formed in the coarsening of the material, mm-hmm, of the minerals. And the dendrites are little tree-shaped structures, microscopic structures in the crystal, and they affect the physical properties, the strength and the density of the material. So on Earth, there are various processes at play, such as sedimentation and convection, but we can eliminate those effects by casting this metal on orbit. So that's the goal of CSLM, is to do the casting without those interfering effects of gravity, and then take the resulting materials back to Earth and examine them, so that we can better understand how to mm-hmm, make metals such as engine blocks or turbine blades. If we better understand the physical processes of coarsening, we can build better materials.
There's some fish on board too, aren't there?
That's right. We flew up 32 Medaka fish on the 32S Soyuz back in October with the crew, and they were living in the aquatic habitat facility in the Japanese module.
Looks just like an aquarium.
That's right. It's a high-tech space aquarium, and so this is a Japanese experiment. The acronym is MOST, for Medaka osteoclast, and the purpose of the experiment is to study how the bones are built and destroyed in zero gravity without, mm-hmm, the effects of Earth's gravity. The osteoclast control the building up process of bones, and so by studying this in zero G, we can better understand what genes and are at work in the production and destruction of bones, and how removing gravity can affect that. And of course, we want to understand these things so that we can keep our crews healthy during long duration space flight. But there's all kinds of benefits and applicability to Earth for people with osteoporosis and other, yeah, bone diseases, to better understand the basic processes of how osteoclasts and osteoblasts work.
So whenever you look at the 5 months you've been the lead flight director for 34, has it been busy? Has it gone by pretty quickly? How's it been?
It's gone by more quickly than I thought it would, and in fact the crew has said the same thing,
yeah,
that each week seems like about a day because it just flies by. They're,
yeah,
very busy on board. But things have gone very smoothly. We've been able to accomplish all the research objectives that we wanted to. We've had a total of 166 experiments on this increment with over 400 principal investigators.
Wow.
So we've gotten a lot of good science done. And again, that was the primary goal. And so it's very gratifying to have to have completed that.
So last question for you. You know, as you look back on the 5 months that you've spent working on this, you know, what's been sort of the biggest, what do you think is the biggest thing that you're proud of, most proud of, and then what's been like the biggest surprise you've had?
Okay, well, the thing I'm most proud of is my team. Yeah. Not only the guys on orbit that have done just great work, but the people here on the ground. As increment lead flight director, I've been privileged to work with a team of lead flight controllers, some of which are here in Mission Control. Others are in our Payloads Operations Center in Huntsville, and the other international partner control centers around the world. So that's been the most gratifying part, is just being part of just an excellent team that has the same vision to advance the cause of human space exploration.
Yeah. Well, Chris, thank you for your time. You know, if you want to learn more about everything that Expedition 34 has worked on, you can always log on to the NASA website at www.nasa.gov/station. Take a look at Ford and Tarelkin and Novitsky, and also take a look at what's ahead for the crew that's coming up at the end of the month that will join Expedition 35 in progress. Of course, they've got a ton of science going on as well. Maybe they will set some records too. So thanks for joining us.